All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sport Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, trying to break it all down here. People, we got some big news. Tyler Shough is transferring. Now, again, the quarterback gets a lot of hype. I've been trying to interview some offensive linemen. If you guys are interested in those interviews, they're up. There will be more coming throughout the offseason. I'm trying to spread them out over time. But everybody loves talking about quarterback. Quarterback is a huge draw. Center of the offense, most important player on the offense, gets the ball in their hands every single time, right? We know the drill. So this is huge news. Now, we knew somebody was going to transfer out of this room. The competition is too deep. There's only one guy that plays as the starting quarterback. For the most part, there's another guy who's backing him up. Barring injury, he's not playing. Maybe some time at the very end of a game in a blowout, last 2 minutes or something. But that, for the most part, the starting quarterback's the guy. And we know this. So last year, again, how it played out, I felt like Tyler was the guy. He coming into the thing, he had the most connection with the guys on the team. Anthony Brown comes in as the transfer, doesn't really get to have that many practices, does his best through the offseason to try to get his workouts in and everything with the guys, but had a real up and down sort of a year when it came to that. Did not get into play early on, and I was very surprised by that. I was surprised by the fact that you didn't see him earlier in the year. Not to say that Tyler, you needed it or whatnot. At that point in time, Tyler was playing pretty well, but the confidence was shook. We saw it. Now, I like Tyler just as much as the next guy. I had him on the show last summer. He gave a great interview. He's a great guy. And he'll do well anywhere. I think he could start at any other school in the conference. But he's a guy who, it felt like once the confidence was shook, it also was shook from the coaching staff, and it felt like they tied his hands. Early in the year, they were throwing bombs, letting receivers go up and make one-on-one plays. They were really utilizing a lot of their different skill sets on their offense. Halfway through the year, the thing tightened up big time. I didn't like the design runs for him. It felt like there were times when it was not a true zone read. It felt like there were times when he was going through the motions of the zone read, but he was there to keep it, and he was getting swarmed. If it's a true zone read, then you can't make that play. If it's a zone read, then he's making the wrong read. So it's either he's making the wrong read, or it's a pre-call to begin with, and it's made to look like it's the other thing. Either way, it's a bad play, and it doesn't look good on film. People are all over the quarterback. They have very high expectations for this program, and the quarterback has to excel. You come off of a guy like Justin Herbert, and you knew that it's going to be a drop-off. It cannot have the same level that the guy was that went to be the rookie of the year in the NFL. But there again, look at Herbert. Look at how they played him at Oregon. Look at how they played him in the NFL. Granted, he had better receivers in the NFL, but he still had a pretty good receiving core here. Not incredibly deep, but pretty good, right? And the idea that early in the year, Shuck was throwing the ball, man. We were going downfield. They were taking chances. I don't know if late in the year that they were willing to take those chances, and that's the writing on the wall. As soon as then they started bringing in the fourth quarter goal line plays for Anthony Brown, or even just anytime during the game, starting to have him in the fourth down plays, goal line situations, that sort of thing, you knew that that was a little sketchy, slippery slope for Tyler. Then all of a sudden, halfway through the bowl game, he's playing pretty much the whole time. Then they put Tyler in a couple times. Was not there to be successful. He put him in and just got thrown to the wolves. Boom. You knew again, like we said, somebody was going to transfer out of here. You just thought it was going to be somebody besides the starting quarterback. It sounds strange when you see the starting quarterback of all the games last year is now in the transfer portal. But you know that the competition is alive and well. Not that Tyler is going to run from competition. I don't think that's the case. But I do understand that Tyler had his opportunity. I feel like there's other guys in the room who are now going to get their opportunity. And that was made very clear to him, that going forward, he was going to have less of an opportunity. The only way that that happens is, if you have an honest conversation with the kid and say, hey, here's the situation. He was able to be here. He was really hoping, as a lot of people were, thinking that Herbert was going to go to the NFL the year earlier when Herbert came back, it put another full year for Tyler to sit and wait on the sideline. Now, that added a lot of time for him to practice or whatever. I get that, trying to develop, sure. But in the rhythm of things, that would have been the year for Tyler to be able to go out, make some mistakes, and if he's the guy, he's the guy. But now it's a kind of a situation where you have all of this talent on this team. You've got these recruiting numbers that are through the roof, and you need somebody in that quarterback position that's going to do the thing that you're expecting them to do. At the end of the year, you didn't get the same results from the expectations that you had for Tyler. Again, that Oregon State game was a killer at the end of that game, and the Cal game, the second half of that Cal game. And those are glaring issues. Now, I did think that people were unfair a little bit with Tyler because everybody loves the backup quarterback. Hey, these guys are in practice. These coaches are million-dollar coaches. If they are going to play the right guy, they're not going to take chances here. There's a lot on the line here. This is very cutthroat competition at the very highest level for D1 players. So the competition's there. I do think that next year you're going to see some competition from the young guys. Now, it's Anthony Brown's job. I mean, that's just obvious. I mean, that's beyond obvious. The guy is 23, 24 years old by this point. I mean, by the time the season starts next year, he is ready to go, okay? Has an extra year. He's been in the program. He's going to have plenty of time to develop. He's not going to have anybody looking over his shoulder. He's going to be the guy, okay? But the two freshmen from last year are going to make some serious noise because there's now a real gap in age between AB at the top and these next guys. And these next guys you got to look at is these three. We got to break these down, right? Obviously, everybody thinks Ty Thompson's going to be the next guy, the next big, great Oregon quarterback, right? Maybe he is. Maybe he isn't. You have to let it come. You can't put these expectations too high on these kids. Yes, he does look like the truth. I totally agree with that, and I'm super stoked, right? Okay, phenomenal. But there's two guys in that room who also think that they got a chance to go. Jay Butterfield, Robbie Ashford. Okay, I really like both of these guys. Now, you're going to have to make a decision at some point and go with one of them. They look different. All three of those quarterbacks look different. So, again, depending on what they do in this camp, the job's going to be open. They're going to go into this year saying anybody can compete for anything. Obviously, we think that Anthony Brown, by him saying he's coming back, basically, it wasn't that's the one big push of Tyler out the door, but had AB left, Tyler probably would have stayed and competed against some of these younger guys. I just don't think Tyler's going to win the job from AB the next year. I think Anthony Brown proved himself that he is a great quarterback when he needs to be at this level. Again, he didn't get the chance to be that great quarterback last year. I think new system, give him another opportunity to have a whole year of practice and under his belt to be able to wheel that offense out, and I think you'll be good to go. I also think, not to give excuses for Tyler, but there's a lot of transition in his time during the offensive coordinator. Having a new offensive coordinator come in, and although Joe Moorhead did do some really good things early on, it felt like defenses caught up to this Oregon offense quickly. And halfway through the year, it was really difficult. And in the bowl game, it was evident that either one, that defense was either that good or Oregon's offense was that stale, okay? And it was really just getting schemed up, right? Doesn't, not to the fault of the players. The players are doing their best. They're playing the plays that are called. So, again, I think that looking forward, you could see this exact same thing happen with AB next year where he comes out, looks really good early on, and then there's a stale point where the defenses catch up to him, and now everybody's saying, hey, bring in the young guy. Again, it's a no-win situation for the quarterback unless you're awesome. If you have any fault at all, people are going to be calling for your job and the next guy up because the next guy at Oregon's going to be looking better because the recruiting numbers are so good. Again, going back to Oregon should have a great quarterback. Oregon should have somebody in their room that can lead this team. I do think it's completely unfair to think that Tyler's a bad quarterback and that he is in any way, shape, or form like Jeff Locke or any of these other guys who we've seen in the past who have not been able to excel at this level. I think he can excel at this level. I just think that there were other factors in the room, and one of them was the fact that he graduated, he's got the option to leave, And now with these new rules, if you're not the guy, go somewhere else. Okay, I think Tyler could make a good quarterback in the SEC, put him behind a good offensive line with a good defense and a good running game. I think he could look the part. Now, the point is that if you have an opportunity for a guy like Ty Thompson to blend with this team and get with this team and go early, then that's fine as well. I just don't think you're going to see a freshman start unless it's a panic situation. Again, Mariota redshirted. Herbert probably would have redshirted had the thing gone the way that should have gone. But when you get off of the Mariota train, again, major step back. You had that quick Band-Aid with Vernon. That was fine. But there was a major, major step back. And you it's hard to replace a guy like that. Again, the guy was the Heisman Trophy winner, the greatest quarterback in Oregon history, right? Until Herbert comes out, and Herbert then goes in the NFL, and in 1 year, it basically is looked at as one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time in Oregon's history. So again, who's the next one? What's the next one going to do? Right? So everybody's getting super hyped on this. You have these quarterbacks come in, you have this level of greatness, you have really high expectations, and you guys have, you know, guys like Dakota Prukup come in. He's not a bad quarterback, but he just wasn't as good as the guys who were before him. And I tend to think Vernon Adams is one of the greater quarterbacks we've had at Oregon too. He just only had 1 year to show it, and he got hurt some of the time, but there's been a great lineage of Oregon quarterbacks, and it felt like this last year the offense was missing something, and it was in that position. We can all agree on that, okay? No offense to Tyler, great kid, great athlete, everything else. It just, there was a time when it felt like this team was not going in the direction that they wanted to go, and it could have been part of the quarterback's issue, okay? Obviously, we know that it's a team game. There's no bigger game in the world than football, more of a team game, and you need everybody to do their part, but it felt like halfway through the year, his confidence had been shot a little bit, and going forward, it was tough for the fans and the coaches to support him in those heavy situations, like goal line, like fourth quarter, fourth down plays. And they switched it over to AB, and you can see the writing on the wall right then. Okay, so I do think next year, I think you're going to have a pretty positive run. You're going to know who the guy is going into camp. I think that should be the way it's done. I think you should say who's going to be the backup. That should be a real big competition there. And then the third quarterback in the room, I think, is still very capable. Again, my dad loves to point out the years where you have quarterbacks get injured and you have to have everybody on board. But I do think there's still going to be some guys who can still play this quarterback position, even with guys we didn't name, who are going to still be in that room. But anything can happen, and especially when you're running quarterback, anything can happen. But I'm really excited for Anthony, and I think that this is going to be a really good opportunity for him to really cement a legacy here and use this last year as a complete gift. The fact that he was able to get another year of eligibility and put himself in a position where he could be the starter of this program going forward. Because again, this is a program at Oregon where they're chasing Pac-12 championships, and Pac-12 championships is the goal. Okay, end of discussion, right? Okay, thank you guys very much. Enjoy the snow up here in Portland. Everybody else out there, stay warm, and we'll talk soon. Adios. Thanks for watching Sports Chat 503, man.